This is our engineers, EVP2500. We are from Group B and we will present our SolidWorks Group assignment. And I'm Arushankar Rudas from Minerals Engineering, second year.
Hello, my name is Anu Shafiqah Binti Abdul Rahman. I'm from Mineral Resources Engineering.
My name is Khairul Yusra Binti Khairul Anwar. I'm from Mineral Resources Engineering.
Hi, nama saya Sarah Binti Ismail from Polymer Engineering.
No, Atira Zahra binti Zaidi Farouk, and I am from Polymer Engineering.
Hi, my name is Siti Nur Haliza, and I'm from Polymer Engineering second year.
Hi, my name is Nurul Nadia binti Azmi. I'm from Polymer Engineering.
I'm Madhuli from Polymer Engineering.
Hi, my name is Nur Suriha binti Zamri. I'm Polymer Engineering student.
Hi, my name is Nur Aina Yasin binti Muhammad Safki. I am from Polymer Engineering student.
Hi, my name is Nur Hamzah Isa
binti
Ahmad Yudin, and I'm from Polymer Engineering student.
I'm Nur Azim binti Abdul Rahman from Polymer Engineering.
Hi, I want to explain the step to do the solid work drawing. Okay, first step, you have to click new on the standard toolbar and select part for new document. This, you click on this, it will appear the new and click the part. Then, okay. After you click the part, you select a file name and create a new sketch. You can do at this field of file name. Okay, for the step 3, create a Z diagram from the origin. Smart dimension, the length and width as given. Make sure the unit is set in mm. This is a Z diagram. Click extrude both or base on the feature toolbar and extrude the sketch. In the property manager under direction 1, select blind in end condition and set width to 40 mm. You can select the blind at this and then set the 40 mm of the width of the width.
I will continue to step 5. A cuboid is then formed, name bones extrude 2. Cuboid, bones extrude 2. Step 6. Change the view to top view for clearer vision. Click here, change the view to top for clearer vision. Next, step 7. Create a circle, set the diameter is 8 mm, make sure the unit is set in mm. Create a circle here and the diameter is 8 mm. Next, we use smart dimension to set the length and the width from center of the circle 9 mm. Width and the length from the center is 9 mm.
For the step 9, click the circle and convert the entities, then copy the entities and move at the distance of 22 meters. Convert the entities, then and move the distance to 22 mm. For the step 10, a new circle is formed. For step 11, click extrude the cut on the features toolbar and cylinder with depth 6 mm is cut extruded from boss extrude 2. The end condition for direction 1 is set as 9. Step 12, cut the extruded 2 is then formed. Use the extruded cut and then.
Okay, for step 13, change the view to isometric view for clearer vision and click fillet and pick H1, H2, H3 and H4 and set the radius to 2 mm. Then for step 14, the fillet are formed, as you can see. So next, step 15, click mirror at the features toolbar. Select boss extrude 2, fillet 2, and cut extrude 2 in bodies to mirror section. In option, select merge solid and propagate visual properties. And for step 16, choose top plane for clearer vision. Draw circle with radius 18 mm.
For step 17, we will choose extrude boss base to extrude the sketch, and
in the property manager, we will set it to direction 1. After that, we will select blind in the end condition. And the depth will be set to 20 mm. After doing the step 17, the cylinder is then formed under the net, boss extrude 4. For step 19, we will select the space and convert the entities. And this is how it will look like.
Next step is by using AstroCAD features, extrude the entities at the end. And draw a circle with diameter 30 mm. After the circle is formed, and click AstroCAD. And the circle here is cut as well as shown you. Thank you.
Okay, so now this is after step 24, this is 25. Then this is how it looks like. And then we need to click extrude boss base on features to boss and extrude the sketch under direction white. We choose. Then we set it on line in the end condition and with the depth up to 80 mm. After that, a cylinder is formed under the name of boss extrude 6. And then we need to draw a circle with a diameter of 20 mm.
So the next will be step 29. We have to click the extrude cut. And circle is cut extruded as shown below. Next, this is how it looks like. Next, choose the top plane for clearer vision. And create a center rectangle, smart dimension, the length 98 mm and width is 6 mm. And this is how it looks.
Okay, for the step 33, we click extrude boss base on the features toolbar and extrude the sketch. Yes. In the property manager under direction 1, we select the line in end condition and the depth we set to 20 mm. And the next step is we sketch the triangle here. And then click extrude cut in features toolbar, cut extrude as shown in below. In the direction 1, set blind and feature scope is selected bodies. Okay. And step 36, create a center rectangle. Smart dimension, the length is 19 mm and the width is 6 mm. For step 36, we use create a center rectangle. We use smart dimension with length 19 mm and width 6 mm. For step 37, we will click extrude boss base on the features toolbar and extrude the sketch in the property manager under direction 1. We will select blind in the end condition and set depth to 20 mm. And then we will sketch the triangle and feature is like this.
For step 39, click extrude the cut in feature toolbar. Cut extrude a circle as shown below. In direction 1, set line and feature scope is selected bodies. For step 40, this is how it looks like. And step 41, save drawing as assignment EBB250 inside part PRT.SLD.PRT. That's all.
As for the 2D sketching, click New in Standard Toolbar and select Drawing for a 2D drawing of the drawing model. Next, select A3 Landscape for the sheet format size. The step 3 is, under Property Manager, open the Finishing Drawing Model in Part Assembly to insert for orthographic drawing purpose. Next, under Property Manager, select Top, Front, Side and Isometric Views in orientation section and edit the drawing nicely in the drawing sheet as shown here.
For the